Since ancient times, man has yearned to fly. It has only been in the last 110 years that we've actually been able to do so, from within the silver tubes that track across our skies. But one Sydney man has spent the last decade and a half trying to fly without wings, and today he did so over our harbour.
David Mayman packed his bags at first light pre-flight. 0 hour was 10 a.m.
That's good. You'll see his hands around there. That's good.
Because David Mayman was going to be as high as a kite by then. For 15 years, it has been David's dream to fly. Through test model after test model, through singed hair at best, to bad burns and a possible drowning at worst, David has chased his dream of self-flight through that decade and a half, finally settling on twin jets used in military drones.
Yeah, well, it runs on avgas or diesel, so you can find your local petrol station and fill up and just fly on.
And it seems David's kith and kin have watched and waited for his dream as well.
There are a lot of people here who he knew, and it was almost like a reunion for us to get together and wish him all the best.
And just before 10 a.m, after putting in the earplugs he'd initially forgot.
Good luck, David.
Thank you. Boom.
David Mayman became a jetpack man. For what seemed like a long, long time till touchdown, David would skim and twist across the waters of the harbour, kicking spray as he cruised low, the heat of the exhaust shimmering behind him, before softly landing back at the Man of War steps.
Congratulations, David. Well done, mate.
Thank you, man. Thank you.
How did it feel up there?
That was awesome. Beautiful day. Just fantastic. The machine's working incredibly well. Yeah. It's like riding a motorcycle, but in the air.
I was a wee bit concerned he'd burnt out a fuse.
Mate, should we be worried about this smoke at all?
No. It's cooling down. This is normal.
And after flying past the Statue of Liberty, across Dubai and over London, the Sydney Sider and his supporters finally realised a long-held aspiration. And Mum was grateful.
He's my little boy. Why wouldn't I be nervous?
But it sounds like that little boy's had a dream for a lot of years.
He has, and he was always a very tenacious little boy. So it's come to fruition, hasn't it?
So, where to from here?
Definitely. Oh, sorry about that.
That's all right. No worries. I love the smell of avgas in the morning.
Mark Dalton, 9 News.